Hi, morning. Now we are going to discuss one more question, another question. This is also asked previous year, NEET and IIT. This is a question here. Yeah, dielectric material. What is dielectric? What is dielectric? Yes, very good. Dielectric means insulating material. Insulating materials. Dielectric means insulating materials. Okay. A dielectric material of dielectric constant. This is what? Dielectric constant. K. Dielectric constant. What is dielectric constant? Dielectric constant, you know, that is a constant. It can be written as 1 by 4 by epsilon naught, isn't it? This is a constant for air. If you place air, this is a permittivity of free space. Epsilon naught is the permittivity of free space. For any medium, this can be written as 1 by 4 pi epsilon permittivity of medium. This epsilon is nothing but epsilon naught and epsilon r. Epsilon r. This epsilon r is, you know very well, that is relative permittivity. Relative permittivity. Yes? It's a basic concept, already we know. It's a basic concept. This is a constant. There are two charges are separated at a particular distance. The force between two charges, F is equal to 1 by 4 by epsilon naught, Q1, Q2 by R square. The 1 by 4 by epsilon naught is a constant. Epsilon naught is a constant when the medium is air between two charges. If there is any other medium, maybe water, or oil, any other medium, that constant can be changed as 1 by 4 by epsilon. Epsilon. Epsilon is the permittivity of medium. This epsilon is nothing but epsilon naught and epsilon r. Epsilon naught and epsilon r. Here the epsilon r, you know very well, this is a relative permittivity. This is 1 for air, you know, this is one for air. This relative permittivity is known as dielectric constant K. This relative permittivity is called dielectric constant K. Yes. So dielectric means insulating medium. dielectric constant is nothing but a relative permittivity. Okay, yes. Then is inserted off portions between the two parallel plate capacitors. For example, this is a parallel plate capacitor. There are two plates separated at a distance d. Area of cross section is A. The plate area of cross section is A. The add medium is placed here between the two plates. Add medium is placed. Then capacitance C is equal to epsilon naught A by d. Is a capacitance of a parallel plate capacitor when add is the medium between the plates. Able to follow? Yes or no? Yes, okay. It's a capacitance of the parallel plate capacitor. Here A is the area of the plate. Area of the plate. D is the distance between the plates. Here the add only be placed. Then only the formula is epsilon naught. Here, what's the problem here? Off portion of the parallel plate capacitor is filled with the dielectric constant, medium of dielectric constant K. That means I will use next color. Off portions, let it be this off portions. Off portion is filled with the dielectric constant, that is K1. Maybe this is K. Dielectric constant is fixed. Okay, are you able to understand? That's half portions. This half portions. Half of this value, that is we placed a dielectric constant K. Here, remaining portion is R only. Then asked to find the value of new capacitance. Are you able to understand the problem? Okay, yes. Dielectric material medium of dielectric constant is filled in the parallel plate capacitor. How this is filled? Half of the portion is filled with the parallel plate capacitor of dielectric constant K. Are you able to understand? Now, what they asked? They asked to find a new capacitor. Definitely there is a change in capacitance since we are placing the dielectric constant inside the plates. What will happen here? Here, we must consider in the type, there are two types of capacitors. This is a capacitor number one, this is a capacitor number two. There is a capacitor filled with the air. Capacitor filled with the medium of dielectric constant K. What are the constant? There are two capacitors here. How can we write? Here, there are two capacitors. There are two capacitors. Are you understand? This is air. Here, air is filled. Here, what? Medium. Previously, this is a single capacitor. After filling the half portion with the dielectric constant K, we must let it be considered two separate capacitors, which is filled with the air, another one is filled with the dielectric constant of medium K. There are two capacitors. Okay, are you understand? Next, one more thing. How these two are connected? Whether this is parallel or series connection. Whether this is parallel or series connection. Maybe this is a capacitor number 1, C1, this is C2. This is C1 and C2. How they are connected? Whether this is parallel or in series connection. Here, these are directions. Here also this is the lead which is connected. Then these two portions are parallel in nature. That means these two capacitors are connected. How? Parallelly. How they are connected? Parallelly. Let it be. We draw like this. Then it's very clear. These two are connected parallelly. Okay, let it be like this one. They are connected parallelly. They are, this is C1, C2, this is filled with the what? Air. This is filled with the what? Medium.
Thoroughly understand?
There are two capacitors. This is a capacitor. Half portion is filled with the dielectric constant of constant medium of dielectric constant K. Then now this is considered as a two separate capacitor which are connected in parallel. In parallel. It's very easy. What's the equivalent capacitance? In parallel. You know very well that is C1 plus C2. Don't understand. Don't understand. C1 is only air. Then the direct formula, just you consider epsilon naught A by D. Okay, one more thing, listen, please. The C1 and C2. What's the thing here? The area of cross section. This is the area of cross section is half of that area of cross sections. That is here. Area is what? New area A by 2. Here, new area A by 2. That is, area is what? Here, A by 2. This is A by 2. The separation is same. There is no change. Separation D is no change. Then what will happen? This is A by 2. Everyone understand? This is the for air. For medium, C medium. That is epsilon naught. Epsilon naught. Then epsilon r. Instead of epsilon r, dielectric constant K. K A by 2. That's our portion. A by 2 by E. Again, this can be written as epsilon naught K A by 2 by D. Next is very easy, you can find it easily. That's a, what's a constant here? That is epsilon naught A by D. Let it be output. That is 2 here. 2 is also here. I will understand. Then what will happen? 1 plus K. 1 plus K. This portion is what? Capacitance. The original capacitance, then this can be written as what? Effective capacitance Cp is what? C by 2, 1 plus K. 1 plus K. C by 2, 1 plus K. Epsilon of A by D. This is C in air. By 2, 1 plus K. That's the thing here. That's the thing here. That is dielectric material of dielectric constant K inserted half portion. It's a very big question mark. Half portions. Half portion means we found the half of the portion is filled. But they are not mentioning about the half portions, whether this is horizontal or vertical. What will happen if it is the case? For example, this is a parallel plate capacitor. Here the half of the portions, maybe this half portions, is filled with the capacitance with medium of dielectric constant K. This is air. What is the effective capacitance? Maybe we derive half portion like this. If it is the case of portions, that is half of the horizontal way, this is filled in the half of the portion of the dielectric constant K, then what will happen? If it is, it's okay, we derive. If it is the case, what will the capacitance? Are we understand? We'll see. In the next video, we will see these derivations. Are we follow? If you want more information related to IIT and NEET physics problems, just you subscribe to this channel. Then only you can automatically, you can, this will be intimated to you. You can see that. This, just try. Otherwise, I will post it in the next video. Are you understand? Thanks a lot.